Hi friends, welcome. Today we see the cricket and its champion, author Nevelly Cordes. Introduction. Nevelly Cordes is a famous writer on cricket. His relationship with cricket began as early as his 13th year. He was appointed a cricket coach at Strawberry School. There began his cricket career, never to end till his lifetime. He is an authority on cricket, and which he has written a voluminous books. He was a equally to authority on music too. For several years, he was serving as a newspaper reporter for Manchester Guardian. This piece, Cricket and Its Champion, is marked by his mastery over the game and by his most facetious style. Cricket summary. It is a poetical expression of Nevelly Cordes about the sensational cricket match. He was a great lover of the game. He used to travel far and wide for witnessing the game. Here he recounts the last match of the season at Cat. In that match, a famous cricketer, Mr. Wole, broke a century record. Beside the uproarious audience, nature also contributed to the grandeur of the match. With its wisp of clouds, chirping of birds and fine dust, the crowd had disappeared after the match. Nevelly Cordes alone slowly saunters across, munching some sweet thoughts about cricket. He is proud of the game, which is the heritage of English. He admires the modesty of spring cricket against the thoroughness of the football. Cricket season. The June, the game is played all over the country. Even small hamlets like Little Petlerton are glorious with these matches and hops. They get a lost in the game. As the season creeps up to August, the game loses its lesser. The players become weary and worn out. Autumn grows in everything. It is a game of absorbing interest. The audience are kept under a spell when it is on. They fall in a fit of reminiscence about the sudden bad stroke, good ball and marvelous catch and the like. Cricket, a magnificent game. It is a game of turn of events and chances. A slow fire will suddenly blaze by a swift and circumstance. In no other game does not small events both max, march and so immediately. As per cricket is concerned, every minute too can become a deciding one. The reaction it causes among the audience is terribly emotional, especially in the large one. One such event happened in a match for rubber between England and Australia, in which A.E. Knight held a magnificent catch for the thrill of the spellbound audience. So cricket means much a man. It represents the English love of compromise between freedom and our lines. The umpires in the magisterial courts exhibit it. They never get any contemptuous treatment as the football refers. Cricket, a magnificent man. Even the cricket fields are reverentially maintained. The game is so inert in their blood that even a lame man has to at least his notions about it. Enjoying a cricket match among the trying busy schedule is a proof of one's Englishness. To put it in other words, no Englishman can resist the temptation of catching a glimpse of cricket match even while he travels past. It is a game of fascination for people of different stratum. One W.G. Grace was a celebrity of the English cricket. The credit for its being a typical English game goes to him. So he became a placed fair wit institution, and so he was comically called Sir Albert Memorial and Sir National Debate, and even as a Sir Cricket. The Champion. The author does not great hero worship about W.C. Grace. A gigantic and swarthy faced man. He described how Grace began his career. Grace used it to practice on the green pastures of Gloucestershire. The silent archer began to creak with the cricket bats. Along with him, the young boys too joined, shouting in all enthusiasm. The labourers passing by heard the sound, but none knew that would be famous cricket man was the unmaking. W.C. Grace. Even before he became a much famous, he could frame a technique of the game into science. His method was quite keeping with in the Western fashion. It is the man who later grew a national renown. Not a match was conducted without his participation. Whether small or big, he always played a conventional game, even in the fashionable arenas. He was a strongly built man with a majestic badge. He is dint of effort and gusto of love for each day's play. Made cricket a national game. Like the Victorians, he believed that authority must fully be exploited. That is why the game became part of the Victorian epoch. The eminence of Grace. Soon he shot up to eminence by his skill and his name for frequently mentioned by all at all places. He became the heartthrob of all cricket lovers. People from various places thronged around the stadium. Inquiry about his health became the thought of the etiquette with a royal family. Young boys took delight in acting and calling themselves. WC entrance fees got announced if Grace participated in any match. The cricket and audience Grace. He showed no discrimination between the country and the country matches. He played both with the greatest and humblest. Wicket keepers deemed it an honor to declare Grace out. The crowd used it to protest against such as umpires who declared him out. Therefore, umpires too hesitated to do so, if for it would disappoint the audience. He was linked up Sopoforth, an acclaimed dangerous fast bowler. This is Gant, a man running with his forward fetch bowling. Was a great fascination to his fan. A celebrity, he used a mingle with a great persons like Lucas, Steele and Stoddart in admiring the talent of players. Grace, the god of cricket fans. While playing for Thornbury, the usual happening got repeated. A rustic revolted against a catch while Grace was batting. Grace took a quarter of an hour conveniences and passively the rustic. Incidents of the kinds used occur in scores. Grace grew one with the cricket and has left an inedible impression by his significant contribution to it ever to be remembered. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, share, like and subscribe.